Chapter 10, Fictional by Definition. Your granddad has used up all the milk again, Grandma said as she opened the fridge. Would you mind popping over to get some from the corner shop? Tilly sighed theatrically. Go on, love, I need some for dinner, and you haven't been outside all day. Get me some licorice all sorts for your granddad. You know how much he loves them, and pick something for yourself, too. Tilly resignedly took the 5-pound note that Grandma handed her and ventured outside. Everything that had happened so far that day had left Tilly thirsty for glimpses of magic leaking through into the real world. But the street remained resolutely normal around her. She snuggled deeper into her scarf against the wind, but as she went to pull her gloves out of her coat pocket, she dislodged the 5-pound note that Grandma had given her, and it danced down the pavement in front of her. She set off after it, only to crash into someone standing in the middle of the pavement with a white sneaker pinning the money down, stopping it from blowing away. Got it, Oscar said, picking up the note and handing it back to Tilly. Thanks, she said, tucking it back in her pocket and hopping from one foot to the other in the cold. Just going to get some milk, Tilly paused. Do you want to come? Sure, Oscar said. The memory of their last conversation hung awkwardly between them. Tilly tried to aim for a safe subject as they walked down the street. Did you have a good afternoon? It was fine, Oscar said. Right then, she said, refusing to be the one to make any more effort. Sorry, I'm not trying to be rude, honestly, but nothing really happened after you left is all. Just lots of customers and cake, the usual. It must be amazing to have a mum own a cafe, Tilly said, her mood thawing quickly, almost as good as a bookshop. It's okay, Oscar said. Mum loves it, but I don't think I'd mind if she decided to do something different. I'm not there much since I'm usually in Paris with Dad over the holidays. I remember you said, do you speak much French? A little bit. Dad used to speak French lots when we were small, but mine gets kind of rusty quickly, and then I feel like I got it all wrong when I'm in France. My dyslexia doesn't help. It doesn't stick in my brain very well. My dad still has to work a lot when I visit, so I spend quite a bit of time with my French grandma, my Mamie. We go into lots of museums and galleries. She used to be an illustrator, and she got me into drawing and art and stuff. Do you have any friends there? Not really. It's kind of hard to meet other kids when you're not in school. There's a boy in our building who I think must be around our age, but he never seems very friendly. My dad invited him over last summer, but he said he couldn't speak any English, even though I'm sure he can. Oscar was interrupted by a loud laugh from a girl from across the street, and they both looked up to see a group of girls from their class on the other side of the road. Isn't that Grace? Oscar asked. Yeah, I think so, Tilly replied. She's your friend, isn't she? Do you want to go say hi? Tilly shrugged. The girls fell about laughing again, and Tilly and Oscar both automatically checked themselves for something stuck in their hair or toilet paper on their shoes. I don't think they're laughing at us, Oscar said, although it came out like a question. I don't think they've even noticed us, Tilly said. But at that moment, Grace raised her hand in a sort of shy half-wave before seeming to think better of it and running after the rest of the group. Tilly hoped Grace hadn't seen her wave back. So you're not friends with Grace anymore, Oscar asked. The sound of laughter had got quieter as the girls turned the corner. Tilly paused. I don't really know, she said. She tried to explain, it's not like you get a letter of resignation or anything. It's just that it got complicated because of secondary school and the netball team and everything. Girls are weird, Oscar said. Do you really think that? Tilly said, disappointed. No, he replied quickly, but I mean, you can see that it's a bit silly that you and Grace aren't friends because of netball. It's not because of netball, Tilly said. It's because of stuff like netball, and it's not silly. You thinking girls are weird is silly. You know, I don't think that at all. I'm sorry, he said. I just don't understand why friendships aren't easier. Why is it so hard just to find someone you like talking to? That should be all there is to it. The problem is that not enough people are best friend material, Tilly said authoritatively. And that's all there is to it. Well, at least you've got your... If you say imaginary friends, I will never speak to you again, Tilly said, staring at him fiercely. But Tilly, they're from books. They're imaginary by nature. They're fictional by definition. I mean, They are fictional, Tilly said, but they're not imaginary anyway. I don't want to talk to you about them. You obviously don't get it. You know what? I have to hurry and get the milk for Grandma so she can make dinner. I'll see you later. Tilly sped past Oscar in a self-conscious blur, leaving him scuffing his heels. 20 minutes later, she thumped the milk down in front of Grandma, who raised her eyebrows. Everything okay? Fine, Tilly said, and stormed off. Tilly, clearly everything is not fine. Come back and tell me what's going on. Grandma called after her. No, leave me alone. I'm going to go read. Tilly shouted back, and Grandma let her go. Tilly reached the second floor, stewing in frustration, and there she found Alice sitting primly on the sofa. Ah, I've been waiting for you, Alice said, standing up. Would you like to come to a tea party?